And now it's time for another tool tip. This tool tip is tip number 3, all about the journal report. The journal report is the most helpful report in the entire QuickBooks software program. It's the most helpful report for 2 reasons. First, the journal shows every transaction ever put into the QuickBooks file. The other reason it's the most helpful report is because the journal is the only report that shows the transactions in the order that they were put into QuickBooks. We call this order entered. Let's take a look. From the main menu, click Reports, Accountant and Taxes, Journal. The journal is only helpful to us if we change the date range to be all, meaning we need the journal to show us all transactions regardless of date. Once we do that, we can stretch it tall and we can see every single transaction that we recorded in this QuickBooks file is listed across the rows of this journal. Notice the first few transactions were invoices, and here are the dates, customers, and money amounts. As we scroll down, we can see that after we entered 8 invoices, we learned about entering sales receipts, and these were the next consecutive transactions that we recorded. You can see any transaction that you previously recorded by opening the journal and simply finding the transaction and double-click. So this sale receipt number 6 can come right up in front of us and we can change anything we want. If we scroll all the way to the bottom of the journal, we see that the date of the latest recorded transaction was January 21 and it was a payment from Allen of $4,000. We can double click and actually see or even edit this payment. Now some of you might be asking, why is this helpful? It is helpful because all the other reports in QuickBooks list the transaction in date order. So, if you recorded the wrong date with the transaction, you won't know where to look on the report to find your transaction. You won't know where it is, because if you put the wrong date, it's in a different order. That's why we need a report that shows the transactions in the order entered, so that we can always find the transaction even if we recorded the wrong date. For example, you were recording an invoice for Betty with a date during the month of February. However, you accidentally recorded the invoice with the date of January. When you try to find it in the customer balance detail, you will be looking in the wrong place because you thought you put the date as February, and you will be looking down here. You don't even remember putting the date as January by accident, so it would not even occur to you to look up here. That's why you need a report that shows the transactions in the order in which they were entered into the computer, regardless of date. Let's change one ourselves and see what happens. Let's change the date of invoice number 12 from January 18 to January 1. We go back to our journal, and our journal is scrolled to the top, so let's slowly scroll our journal all the way down to the bottom. We notice that invoice number 12 is transaction number 18. Invoice number 12 is 5 from the very bottom of the journal. Here it is. Now, let's also take a look at this very same invoice on the customer balance detail. The customer balance detail shows the section of candy here, and we can see this is invoice number 12. It's dated January 18, and it's the same money amount here as it was in the journal. Let's double-click here on the invoice number 12 dated January 18, and let's change the date to January 1. Now look what happens to the report when I click Save and Close. Yes. Aha. Invoice number 12 for 2380 has jumped from the bottom of the candy section to the top of the candy section. And that's because customer balance detail lists all transactions in date order. However, when I come back to the journal, I notice that invoice number 12 is still transaction number 18. Invoice number 12 is still 5 transactions from the bottom of the journal. Invoice number 12 is still in the same position in the journal as one of the most recent transactions that we can find easily by going to the bottom of the journal. The only thing that's different is the date. So let's fix it and change it back. Double click in your journal, change the date back to January 18, and click Save and Close, and Yes, and notice the date changes, but in the journal, the position of number 12 stays the same. If we go back to the customer balance detail, we see the transaction for invoice number 12 has now moved back to the correct position. It will be very helpful for you to remember that the bottom of the journal has the most recently entered transactions. Sometimes you are putting in a large variety of transactions in one session. If you forget where you left off, you can just look at the bottom of the journal. If I open my journal and I scroll all the way to the bottom, I can see the very last transaction that I entered was the payment on January 21st from Alan. The second to last transaction I entered was the payment on the 20th from Betty, and so on. So if you are doing a large amount of data entry with a big variety of transactions, and you get distracted during the data entry session, and you cannot remember the last one that you put, simply open the journal, scroll to the bottom, and then you will know.